why do children do not do well? I'm sure many of you must have seen such scenes where children are not doing well and the frustration appears not only in the child's or in the teacher's mind, but the entire family. They undergo severe stress and strain if the child doesn't perform as per the expectations of the teacher and the parents. Now, we all know that there are many causes or many reasons the children do not do well because of many of these reasons. The causes or the factors could be in the child himself, in the school and the teaching methods, in the family, or in the society. Like when there was serial bomb blast in Mumbai, for months together the children were not able to do anything in the school. There was severe emotional disturbance reactions seen in many children's minds. So environment plays also an important role in performance of every child in society. Today I am going to restrict to only one particular specific cause because of which the children do not do well in the school, and many a times they are named, they are blamed, and they are sometimes even removed from the school, and that hampers the child's progress very, very severely and very seriously. Before that, I will just give you one example. I was working in Sion Hospital as head of the Department of Pediatrics. I am basically a child specialist, and I started looking at these problems when the children were not performing well. The children who do not develop well, they have developmental problems like mental retardation, cerebral palsy, hearing impairment. And during that period, we also came across some children who were probably having learning disability or dyslexia. So my today's talk is mainly concerning or concentrating on the specific learning disabilities. But before that, I'm just going to go through a common story. This was the patient who was referred to Sion Hospital. With the example of this story, I will get the point across about the learning disability problem in children. Now, this was the boy whose name was Aman. He was 8 years, 4 months old, studying in English medium in Mumbai. Miss Nathan was the newly appointed English teacher who had noticed the child had very poor handwriting, very bad handwriting. It is called illegible handwriting. And he was making many spelling mistakes while doing the writing work. She was not sure whether this problem of writing illegibly with lot of spelling mistake was because of his left-handedness or because he did not know how to write. So she thought it was probably because of his left-handedness. The child was writing with the left hand and used to feel very sweaty, and the hands used to become wet and cold. So she felt that probably this was the reason child was not able to write properly. She had also noticed very untidy appearance of this child. Buttons in wrong holes, socks falling out of the shoes, shirt hanging out from the back. The other features that she had noticed in this child were arithmetic was very poor, but he was very good in giving oral answers. Means his handwriting was poor, but he had understood the subject or the question and was coming out with proper answers, correct answers to those questions. Miss Nathan, the teacher, encouraged him to do better and ask him that why is he making so many mistakes in writing. So what he said was very interesting, because many times we as parents or teachers do not ask why is he doing that. We always describe how that child is doing and we disapprove the way in which he is doing certain particular things. So she asked, why is he not doing well in the class? He says, or as far as writing is concerned, he said, I do try, but it never comes right. I know what I want to say, but the words do not come out of my head into my hand. See how simply he was putting. It was very interesting to find out his way of analysis of his own problem in his own words. Miss Nathan went to the school principal and explained the school principal that this is what this Aman is doing. School principal felt that he is still young, he is just 8 years. You should wait before considering referral for any special education or any assessment. He may improve himself when he grows older. This is a very, very common statement that is said not only by the principals but also by the grandparents, parents sometimes, the neighbors, the friends. They always advise, just wait, when he grows up he will be alright, or just wait, she should be alright within 2 years. So same thing the principal felt in this case and said, right now there is no need to refer to any specialist, just wait and hold on. Miss Nathan met the parents of this child and explained them her observation, and the parents also agreed that they had also seen something similar. The child was smart, child was able to give answers, child was able to understand. But when it came to writing, reading and doing mathematics, he was having problems. Parents were concerned and anxious as there was no improvement in the next 6 to 7 months. At this time, Aman developed certain behavioral problems. Behavioral problems means the emotional problems like irritability, depression, doesn't want to mix with children, doesn't want to go to play, wants to be all by himself inside the room working on the or playing on the computer. So these were certain behavioral problems that were noticed at home as well as in the school. He was referred to a psychologist. For the next year, 1 year, there was no effect in the Aman's behavior. Parents felt that this school is not suitable for him and the teachers are not teaching properly. So they changed the school. Aman started going to another school. From that school, this child was referred to Learning Disability Clinic for further assessment. After doing the assessment, he was diagnosed to have dyslexia, dysgraphia, and dyscalculia. Dyslexia means difficulty in reading, dysgraphia means difficulty in writing, and dyscalculia means difficulty in doing mathematical calculations. Now, by this time, when the diagnosis was made, the child was already 11 years old. That means there was loss of crucial years for remedial work in this child's case. This is a typical story of many of the dyslexic children that we see in our society. And not only in our society, but most of the outside countries also, the similar story is shared by many of the professionals working in this field. What are the implications of this delayed diagnosis? There are educational implications, psychological implications, social, medical implications affecting the personality development of that particular child. So today I thought I will concentrate on these specific learning disability issues, which are not very commonly discussed, which are not very commonly shared, and even The teachers are not very well aware of this problem, which has come to light in the last about 15 or 16 years or so. How many of you have heard that there is a GR for children who are having disabilities and they get certain provisions, or in layman's language it is called concessions, but these are not concessions, these are provisions or also called as accommodations. Any one of you has heard about them?
Yes.
For ADHD.
Yeah, but I don't know whether it is there for dyslexics.
Yes. And there are certain provisions for blind children, certain children, provisions for deaf children. So these disabilities, the children who have disabilities, like CP children, many of you must have heard about Spastic Society of India.
Yeah.
And Mithu Alur was the first person. She started the special school, one at Kulama and one at Bandra, and she started the movement about the provisions or the accommodations for spastic children. These are the children with lot of physical issues and physical problems. So in Maharashtra, the problem of learning disability or specific learning disability was recognized only in 1996, that is about 15 years ago, when the state government of Maharashtra education department recognized the problem and declared some provisions or concessions for children having this problem. So before we go over to that, first let us see what is this problem and how the whole concept of specific learning disability has come in the picture. First of all, let me explain you what is this learning disability, how common it is. It is a neurodevelopmental disorder. That means it has to do something with the brain and something with the development of the child. All our actions, all our skills are based on the intactness of the brain. If the brain is all right, the brain has proper command and proper strength to inform all the parts of the body in a correct way, the skills are developed properly. The walking skill is a natural, because each and every baby has to walk, whether the baby is born in Mumbai or New York or Chicago or Japan somewhere. The baby has to walk by 1 year of age. That's why it is said one to walk and two to talk. So each child should start walking by 1 year, which is a genetically coded program. And even if you put the baby tied up to the cot for 6 hours in a day, the remaining 18 hours, the baby will try to develop herself or himself. So these are natural skills which do develop irrespective of the surrounding situations. But the learning to read, learning to talk, learning to do mathematics, these are acquired skills, just like learning to drive a car. It is not naturally empowered, genetically decided. Some may have better adaptation to development of these skills. Some may have special power to develop these skills early. But these are not naturally developed or naturally developing skills. So they have to be trained in doing certain skills that one needs to show. So therefore, learning disability is a neurological problem and developmental problem. It occurs in about 5 to 15% of population. Means it is a very common problem. If I tell you all the features, you will remember, oh, in my school probably that child or that boy or that girl had this problem and it was probably not noticed. Equally distributed in girls and boys or male and female, they persist throughout the life. And most likely to be familiar. That means if the father or mother